Good afternoon, everyone. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, sir.
Did you get the routine for your exam, semester exam?
No, sir.
No, sir.
Okay. Okay, okay. Okay, check whether the screen is visible or not.
Visible, sir.
Okay, okay, fine. And I hope all of you have seen your CA4 marks. Was it showing?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. Okay. Okay, in previous class, your module 4, that is the based on machine, two topics were remaining. Okay, first topic was your first single phase induction motor, and second topic was synchronous motor. Okay, so I am just postponing those two topics. Those two topics will be discussed on Monday. Okay, so today we will start a new chapter, that is the chapter 6. Okay, electrical installation. Mainly from this chapter you will get MCQ questions, 2 marks question, okay, and short note type question, right? So in this semester, I hope all of you know the type of question that may be given to you during the exam. Only 1 mark question and 2 marks question. Okay, so regarding that 2 marks question, this chapter is very important. Okay, so module 1, module 2, module 3, module 4, module 6, these five modules are important. I am leaving the module 5, okay, because you can learn that, but if you try to understand all the module 5 topics, then it will be so problematic for you. Okay, so better you focus on module 1, module 2, module 3, module 4 and module 6. Okay, I will upload the module 5 topics and its PPTs and whatever animations I have in Google Classroom. Okay, you can go through there. No problem. Okay, so now without wasting any time, we are starting this electrical installation chapter. Okay, what is in the electrical installation? At home, you have seen switches, you have seen circuit breakers, you have seen some devices that controls the voltage, like voltage regulator. Okay. So what are the functions of these installing devices? What is the requirement? Okay, that will be discussed in this chapter, right? So basically electrical installation tells you that what appliance you should use to safeguard your appliance, to safeguard your instrument. Okay, so it is called basically a switch gear. Okay, switch gear, then definition of LB/LT switch gear, next reason for using the switch gear. Okay, just a minute. Next, component and function of the switch gear, then type of switch gear, then few questions. Okay, MCQ questions. So what is basically switch gear? The switch gear is the component that disconnect the switches like fuses or circuit breakers. Okay, like you are creating one electrical circuit. Okay, you are creating one electrical circuit, this one, and it is one resistor, using one resistor. Okay, this is 10. This is your 5 ohm. Okay, so 2 ampere current will flow, right? So basically what we do, we will use one switch here. Okay, as soon as we close the switch, the current will flow. Okay, now why this switch is required? This switch is required because when you connect this 10 volt DC source, you will see that in these sections, these nearby sections, you will see sparking. Okay, but if that sparking occurs, it will be very dangerous for the person who is using. Okay, since it is 10 volts, so it is not that much dangerous. But if it is 220 volt DC, 500 volt DC, then it is dangerous. Okay, so that's why we need a switch. Right, so basically that instruments we use to control, to protect and isolate the electrical equipment is called the switch gear. Okay, the instrument that is used to control, protect and isolate the electrical equipment is called the switch gear. Okay, you have seen some fuse, okay, where lights will glow, this kind of fuse. Okay, you will see two lead, right? Why this? And in between these lead, one wire is connected always. Okay, when you went to your shop, if you will, they will ask that whether it is 2 ampere fuse or 5 ampere fuse. Okay, because that rating determines the maximum capability of this fuse. Okay, why it is required? If more than, suppose it is 5 ampere fuse, okay, if more than 5 ampere flows through this device, it will be problematic, it will be very dangerous for the instruments connected at home. Okay, that's why this 5 ampere fuse is connected. So if more than 5 ampere is flowing through this fuse, this wire will melt and disconnect the total electrical supply. Okay, so it is basically the safeguard device, right? Now, what are the features? Manual control provision. Okay, you can manually control it. Second, fast operation. Third, completely certain discrimination, that means total isolation. And number four, entire reliability. Okay, now there are different types of switch gears that we use and their working functions are also different. Okay, but one thing is common, that they either protect or they isolate the device. Okay, now what are the components of the switch gear? These are various types of switch gear, as you can see. Okay, and based on their working function, there are mainly two components. Okay, one is power conducting and control, and second one is the control system. Okay, one device just conducts the power from one point to another, and second one is to control the system, like fuse. Okay, it conducts the electricity, right? But see the voltage regulator that is sometimes attached with the fridge, refrigerator. Okay, the voltage regulator. So this voltage regulator is used to control the voltage. If your voltage is getting down, is decreased than the normal, suppose your rated voltage for that fridge is within a particular range, like 200 to 220, but your voltage just getting decreased below 200, like 195, then what will happen? The fridge won't work, it will shut down if you don't connect the voltage regulator, right? Now, if you use the voltage regulator, what it will do? It will boost up the voltage. It will regulate the voltage. Okay, if the voltage is more than 220 volt AC for that fridge, then it will be again harmful for that fridge. So voltage regulator do what? It will decrease the voltage. Okay, so that is the two types of component based on the power conduction and the controlling the system, right? Now power conducting like fuse, switches, circuit breaker, lightning arrester. Okay, and control system like control panel, transformer like potential and current protective relay, connected circuitry controls, monitors and protect the components of the power conducting. Okay, also you can say that voltage regulator is also here. Okay, voltage regulator. So as you can see here, there are different types of switchgear systems that we use. One is vacuum circuit breaker, load switch, load bridge switch, SF6, medium voltage transformer, medium voltage current transformer, toroid current transformer, and digital protective relay. Okay. Now, this is one kind of circuit breaker. You can see there are three fuses connected here. One fuse. Okay, I hope you can see the dots. Second fuse, third fuse. Because it is mainly, this circuit breaker is mainly connected for three phase systems. Okay, so that's why three phase are there. One is for R phase, one is for Y phase, another one is for the B phase. Okay, next one is the current transformer and potential transformer. What is current transformer? We call HCTPT. Okay, current transformer and potential transformer. Current transformer did what? It basically checks the current value. Okay, if your primary, suppose current transformer did what? This is one type of current transformer. Okay, one secondary is there, and here we connected one relay type. Okay, suppose here the rated value is 100 ampere. Okay, here rated value is 1 ampere. Right, so if this device observes that your current value just increases up to 1.1, if it goes above 1 ampere, like 1.1 ampere, then it isolates the current supply. Okay, and here the current supply also gets disconnected. Okay, that is the function of the CT. Just like that, PT will work likewise. Okay, if the voltage is increased than the rating, then it will just stops the voltage. It will just isolate the circuit, isolate the device from the main supply. Okay. Next one is the protective relay. This is one kind of relay, digital relay. Okay. Now, you can see here, what is the current flow in phase A? Okay, phase I1, phase I2 and phase I3. Likewise, it gives you their digital values of the current flowing. Okay. Next one is the measuring instrument. Measuring instrument, and next one is the switches. There are different kinds of switches. If you have taken part in robotics, then you have used three types of switches, like this one, on-off switch, this three-pin switch, on-off neutral mode, okay, then this regulation switch, okay, this regulation switch, it is used for speed regulation, okay, and next one is this switch. It is used to change the voltage level. Okay, you have you can see here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Like these points are given. It means that in this coil here, one coil is there. Okay, their tappings are done. Right. So these are various types of switches. Now, next, fuses. Here, several kinds of fuses you can see here. Okay, and if you have an inverter at home, the backside of the inverter, you can see one fuse is connected like this. Okay, this kind of fuse of red color or blue color fuse was connected, right? And at the backside of this fuse, at the backside of this fuse, it is written like 40 or 32, like this. So it defines that the maximum value of current flow it can withstand. Okay, maximum amount of current flow it can withstand. Here, if 40 ampere is written, if you can see the 40 ampere is written on the backside of this kind of fuse, then that means it can carry maximum 40 ampere. If accidentally due to overcurrent, if this current value is more than 40, like 41 or 45, then it will trip the circuit. Okay, then you will see that you will hear one shrill sound coming out from the your inverter. Okay, then this kind of fuse you will see at car, in the car you will see this kind of fuse you will see in the car, car's engine. Okay, then another type of fuse is also there, that is called glass fuse. Okay, you have those who play video games or do the electrical wirings. Okay, they sometimes used the extension board. Okay, in that extension board you will see when you switch on, there is one light glowing. Okay, and it is of like this square shape. Okay, so that is the fuse inside. There is one fuse inside. Okay, that is one kind of light, that is called the glass fuse. Okay, it is called glass fuse. It is basically due to the to safeguard that device, to safeguard your wirings inside your extension board. Okay, next one is the isolator, surge arrester and miniature circuit breaker. This surge arrester, isolators, these devices were used for high voltage supply, like your 200 kV, 500 kV, like this. Okay, then it is miniature circuit breaker. This miniature circuit breaker, we call it MCB. MCB. Okay, at home near your electrical supply, electrical meter from where the supply is coming at home, you will see that this a switchboard is there where several numbers of MCBs are connected. Okay, it is done, this connection of MCB is done to safeguard your home from the short circuit or from the overload or from the lightning also. Okay, it is called miniature circuit breaker. There are several kinds of miniature circuit breaker based on their ratings. Here you can see it is written as 63 ampere. Okay, that means maximum amount of current flow that it can withstand is 63. Okay. Next one is this isolator. Okay. It basically did what? Suppose this is one transmission line. Okay. And I am connecting here one isolator. Okay. So if any kind of fault occurs here, then what will I do? I will just rotate this isolator like this. There is one hinge, one rod is there. Okay, one rod is there. It is connected to the ground. It will rotate. Okay, and it isolates the two sections. Suppose this is section one, this is section two. In case of high voltage, these isolators are used. Right. Now, what are the functions of the switch gear? It protects the equipment from the short circuit and fault current. Okay. This device gives isolation to the circuits from the power supply. Second. Third, it increases the availability of the system by allowing more than one source to feed a load. That means what? Suppose there is one resistor here. Okay, there is another resistor here, there is another resistor like this, more resistors, more sections are there. Okay, and there are two sources. Okay, which is feeding this load. Okay, like this. So in case of this kind of connection, your switch gear is required, because you have to choose which supply will work at what condition, right? So for that case, you need to use the switch gear. Next one is, it can open and close the electrical circuit under conditions of normal and abnormal condition. That means abnormal means nothing but the short circuit case. Okay. Now, in normal conditions, it can operate manually and it ensures the safety of the operator and also the proper electrical energy utilization. Okay. In abnormal condition, it operates mechanically. Once the fault happens, the device detects it and detects the damaged part, just like the MCB. Okay. If you use one MCB, if you have seen one MCB or RCCB, okay, if you have seen MCB or RCCB, this is RCCB, okay, then you will see that if more than the rated current flows through MCB, it will automatically switch off, it will automatically disconnect the circuit. Okay, you don't need to operate it, it will automatically disconnect, right? Just like that, the RCCB, the residual current circuit breaker. Okay, if it sees any change in the current flow, if it will see the change in current flow, okay, if it sees any change in the current flow, then it will disrupt the circuit. It will isolate your working section from the supply. Okay. Next, what are the essential features? First, reliability. Next, absolutely certain discriminations. Quick operations. Provision for manual controls and the provision for instruments. That means, what is the meaning of provision for instruments? That means you can connect there some measuring devices also, like ammeter, voltmeter, wattmeter. You can also use tachometer. Okay, like that. Next, what is the consideration which must be done while using the switch gear? That means you have to consider where you are using this device, whether you are using it inside the house or outside the house. Okay, your location is very important, because if you use fuse that outside the house, then what will happen during the rainy season? Water will go into the fuse and it will create one major short circuit case. So we cannot use fuse at outside condition. Okay, so that this location is very important, whether it is indoor or outdoor. Okay, next one is the system parameters, like the frequency. This is very important, frequency. Next, insulation level, the ambient condition. Okay, why insulation level is required? Because you will see that when the wiring is done at home, you will see that whoever the person is, whoever doing the wiring at home, he will ask that I need 4 mm wire, I need 8 mm wire, okay, 16 mm wire, like this. It means this 4 mm, 8 mm, 16 mm wire, these wire, what is the difference? The difference is their current carrying capacity and its insulation level. Okay, you will see some wire whose insulation level is so thick that any kind of mechanical damage it can withstand. Okay, there is over the wire there is the insulation of first the polymer, then steel, then again polymer. So it can withstand any kind of mechanical damage, and if this kind of wire can be used in underground cases. Okay, next, the erection of the switchgear. Next, switchgear commissioning. So there are several considerations that should be done. Next, the classification. The classification of switchgear means we can differentiate the usage of switchgear based on different cases. Like if your current rating is different, then you have to use different kind of switchgear. Then the interruption rating. Then voltage class. Now in case of voltage, there are three kinds of voltage: low voltage, medium voltage and high voltage. What is low voltage? If it is less than 1 kV. If it is less than 1 kV, then it is called the low voltage level. Okay. When it is medium, when it is more than 1 kV, but less than 35 kV. Right. Next, if it is more than 35 kV, then it is high voltage. Right. Then the insulating medium. Insulating medium is like air, gas, oil or vacuum. So if there is air as the insulation medium, then there are several types. Okay, you might have heard one circuit breaker like SF6 circuit breaker. That is one gas type circuit breaker. Okay, sulfur hexafluoride gas is used, SF6. Okay, sulfur hexafluoride. Next one is the construction type. Indoor, outdoor, industrial, metal enclosed. Okay, type of current, that means the different kind of switch gear for AC and for DC. By application, that means transmission system and distribution system. Operating method, like manually or motor or stored energy, that means it will work automatically. Right. Next, the switchgear types. Low voltage switchgear. Here all the switchgears that you are observing, they are low voltage switchgears. Okay. Like low voltage circuit breakers, HRC fuses. HRC means high rupturing capacity. High rupturing capacity fuse. Okay, next, the earth leakage circuit breaker, MCB and MCCB. They are all for low voltage switch gear. Right. Now, next, the medium voltage switch gear. Medium voltage means like SF6 circuit breaker. This, that is one medium voltage switch gear. Okay. Now, one oil circuit breaker, that is also one medium voltage switch gear. Okay, SF6 can also used for high voltage also. Okay. Next, this is the high voltage switch gear. Okay, it is more than 36 kV. So basically, from this section, there are medium voltage, low voltage and high voltage, you will get maximum the short notes. Okay, like 2 marks MCQ questions or maximum 3 marks. Okay, their features, how many types of switch gears are there based on their working function. That means what I discussed already, based on current rating, based on voltage rating, based on their interruption. Okay, that you have to write at the time of, if that question is given. Next, these questions were already given in exam. Okay, what is the importance of the switch gear? What does the switch gear do? What's the difference between the switchboard and switch gear? Next, what is the switch gear component and what is MB switch gear? These questions were given in previous year. Okay, you can go through all these topics. Next. Here, we will discuss the various types of LVLT switch gear. SFU, that means switch fuse unit. Okay, now different types of SFU, miniature circuit breaker, different types of MCB, and what is the difference? Okay, various types of LVLT switch gear I already discussed, right? Now, this box is so similar. You are familiar with this kind of box. Okay, there is one lever which, if it is moved down, then this connection will open. Okay, the current flow will stop. This is porcelain switches. These switches are called, these switches are made of porcelain. Okay. P-O-R-C-E-L-I-N. Okay, these are the porcelain switches. Now, these switches are of maximum 64 ampere rating. 64 ampere, very high current it can withstand. Okay, and this kind of fuses were also, and the two leads of these fuses, you will see that there are two leads like this. One lead is here, okay, that is very thick. Another lead is also here. Okay, and you have to wound one wire like this. Okay, one copper wire, one naked copper wire, you have to wound like this. So if that more than this rated current flows, this wire will burn. Okay, and it will disconnect the supply. Okay, this is the switch fuse unit. Now, there are several kinds of fuses. One is AC fuse, another one is DC fuse. Okay, in case of we normally, for our general life cases, in our daily basis cases, we don't use DC that much. Okay, mainly we are familiar with the usage of AC kind of fuses, right? Total two kinds of fuses, high voltage and low voltage. Now, three high voltage types of fuses are there: Curtidge type, liquid and expulsion. And if you choose the low voltage fuse, there are Curtidge type, dropout, rewirable, striker fuse and switch fuse. Curtidge fuse is of two type, D type and link type. Okay. See, their detailed description is not basically needed. You just have to remember their types. Okay, how many types of fuses are there? If you write only AC fuse and DC fuse, you will not get that much marks. Okay, so you have to remember what are the names, what are the types of the fuses. Okay, I will show you all the images, all the pictures. Okay, try to remember with the picture, then it will help you to remember the difference between the fuses. Okay, see, this is the rewearable fuse that I told you, one porcelain fuse. Okay, it is the rewearable fuse. That means the fuse where, if the wire is molten, if the wire is disconnected due to excess current flow, then just remove that wire and then attach one new wire. That is the rewearable fuse. Okay. Next is cartridge type fuse. This kind of cartridge type fuse and the glass type fuse you will see in the extension boards. Okay. In the long extension board. These are all low voltage fuses, the cartridge fuses, and you may have seen this kind of cartridge fuses in the inverter also. You may see. Okay. You can also see this kind of fuses in inverter also. Next, this is the link type fuse. Okay, link type fuse, and it is mainly HRC fuse. Okay, it is the HRC fuse. Now, next one is the blade and bolted type fuse. This is called the blade and bolted type fuse. Also in inverter you can see this kind of fuse on the back side. Okay, I told you that on the top side, like here, you will see it is written either 30 ampere or 40 ampere it is written. Okay, it is the maximum capacity of this fuse. Right. Next one is the striker type fuse. This is the striker type fuse. Okay, switch type fuse, that means that you use in the switchboard. Okay, this is the high voltage fuse that is used for only high voltages like 15 kV. If the voltage is greater than 15 kV, then you have to use this kind of fuses, right? Like the transformer, in synchronous machines you have to use. Okay, in transformers, then high voltage alternators. Okay, alternators means synchronous machines. Okay, high voltage alternators, so there you have to use this kind of fuses. Next, cartridge type fuse. Then liquid type HRC fuse. In this is very unique type of fuse, liquid type. Okay, here you are observing the copper coil. Okay, the wound copper coil, it is basically dipped into the oil. Okay, oil or high rupturing capacity liquid. Okay, high insulating capacity liquid, right? See, it is also written here, this kind of fuse is packed with carbon tetrachloride. That means CCl4. Okay, that liquid is basically carbon tetrachloride. Or you can use some high insulating oil also. Okay. This is the expulsion type HV fuse. It is basically for the protection purpose, nothing else. What are the applications? This is also very much important for your MCQ type question. Okay, for maximum 2 marks or 3 marks. It is used for power transformers, the electrical appliances like ACs, TV, washing machines. Next, third, the electrical cabling, that means your wiring at home. Then mobile phones, there you are also using one fuse. If you open the your charger, you will see, right? Next, motor starter in laptop, the power chargers, cameras, scanner, printer. Since the scanner and printer, for this case we need fuses because they need high amount of current for functioning. Okay, high current, because they need high current for functioning. Next, automobiles, electronic devices and gamings, different kinds of fuses were discussed and they are required. Okay, this is miniature circuit breaker. Okay, their internals are already shown here. Okay, their details description is not in your syllabus, I just noted here. Okay, working principle is also not required for you. Okay, only you have to know this portion, that why MCB is required. Okay, for overload protection, because they have bimetallic strip which causes the circuit to open. And second, the short circuit protection. Okay, it has the electromagnetic kind of thing, that means electromagnetic attraction is there. Okay, so two kind of protection it can do, it can give, it can provide. One is overload protection, another one is short circuit protection. Okay, this is very important, this thing you have to remember. Okay, next, this type of MCB is very important. The details description is not needed, but the types of MCB and the characteristic, it is needed. Okay, so basically total five types of MCBs are there: B type, C type, D type, K type and Z type. Okay, and then if you bought one MCB, you will see that below the MCB their ratings, the company name, how much current it can withstand, that means basically its rating is already noted. Okay, like this, see here, it is written here B32, that means it is of B type, right? It is of B type, and maximum 32 ampere it can withstand. If it is lower, that means it is in off mode. If it is lower, then it is in off mode. If you move like this, it will be on. Okay, and when it will, when it senses the current flowing through that MCB is more than 32 ampere, then you will see that it will automatically go to the off mode. Okay, it will go automatically to the off mode. Next, see here, C type MCB is this of 16 ampere. Here D type MCB of 100 ampere. All their ratings are written, how much voltage rating, the their breaking current rating. Okay, all those ratings are there, right? Now, based on the number of poles, there are different MCBs. Okay, normally at home, single pole MCB like this, single pole MCB is used. Okay, sometimes you will see the double pole MCB. If you look the, if you come visit our laboratory, our basic electrical laboratory, you will see that four pole MCB was also there. Okay, three pole MCB was also there. Single pole MCB was also there. Okay. Next, this is important also, the difference between the fuse and the circuit breaker. Okay, difference between the fuse and the circuit breaker. Now, how it is differentiated based on their principle, based on their function. Okay, based on their working principle, that means if it is a fuse, then the electrical thermal properties of the conductor material, based on that the fuse is working. but circuit breaker, it doesn't matter. It mainly works based on the electromagnetism principle. Okay, then fuse, it can be used only once, the fuse, because if it is not rewearable, if it is rewearable fuse, then you can just change the wear and you can use that fuse also, like the porcelain fuse I have shown you. Okay. But in circuit breakers, it can be used for a number of times. Okay. Then the status indication. In case of fuse, you cannot check the status whether it is connected or disconnected. But in circuit breaker, it gives the indication. How? The pole, this pole, it will move downward. That means it is basically off. Your total connection flow is totally disrupted. Okay. Next one is the auxiliary contact. No auxiliary contact is there, fuse, because its construction is very simple. But in circuit breaker, yes, there is one auxiliary contact. Next, switching action, the temperature, characteristic curve. Now, in case of fuse, if you change the wear, the characteristic curve will be different. But in case of circuit breaker, it is always same from the time of manufacturing. Okay, then protection. The fuse only protects the device against the overload. That means when the current is flowing more than the rated value. But in case of circuit breaker, it provides the protection for overload and short circuit. So this is very important. Okay. Next, its function. That means it provides both detection and interruption process. In circuit breaker, performs only the interruption, and faults are detected by the relay system. Right, then braking capacity is not required for you, operating time is not required, version is not required. Mode of operation, yes, it is required, because fuse completely automatically disconnects. Okay, and circuit breaker disconnects the switch, but when you need to switch on, you have to do it manually. Okay, the cost of fuse is low, but the circuit breaker is relatively high. Okay, so that's for today, and in next class we will learn this MCB, ELCB and RCCB. Okay, so thank you everyone. Now yes,
so can we apply a single phase of 4 MCB instead of 4 pole MCB?
Yes, 4-pole MCB is required for a 3-phase system, like your 3-phase transformer, 3-phase, any kind of 3-phase machines where it is connected like star connection, then 4-pole is required.
So can we apply a 4 single MCB of single phase instead of 4-phase 4-pole MCB?
For single-pole MCB, you can apply, but it will not give you that much protection. Because listen, in case of 3-phase, R phase, Y phase, B phase, and if it is connected like in the form of neutral, like star connection, then one neutral will be there. So total 4 points you can get. Okay. So if you connect there 4 single pole MCB, then simultaneously you cannot operate all the 4 points. Okay, but if you use the 4-pole MCB, then you can simultaneously operate on 4 points like R phase, Y phase, B phase and also the neutral. Because if any short circuit or any overload condition occurs, then you don't need to off any one phase, you have to off the whole device, isn't it?
Yes.
हाँ, तुमको पूरा डिवाइस ही बंद करना पड़ेगा. कोई एक फेज ऑफ करने से मुझे कुछ सुविधा नहीं, मुझे कोई मतलब मुझे कुछ इफेक्ट नहीं पड़ेगा. ठीक है, वी हैव टू क्लोज ऑल द फेजेस. सो दैट्स व्हाई इफ यू यूज सिंगल पोल एमसीबीज देन इट विल बी डिफिकल्ट. यू हैव टू स्विच ऑफ द फर्स्ट सिंगल, फर्स्ट आर फेज, देन वाई फेज, देन बी फेज. सो इट इज लिटिल बिट प्रॉब्लमेटिक. ओके
यस,
इज दैट क्लियर और एनी डाउट वाज देयर आल्सो? Is there any doubt?
This is clear, but I have also one question more.
Yes, please.
In main phase, we use a fuse of 6 ampere.
Fuse and, of 6. Yes, you can use 6 ampere, yes.
Yeah, and for every single room, we use MCB. So can we control all the system by MCB or a fuse?
please repeat once.
सर हमारे मेन फेज में 6 एम्पियर की फ्यूज लगी होती है मेन बोर्ड में और हर रूम के लिए एक एमसीबी अलग से लगाना पड़ता है. तो क्या हम सिर्फ एमसीबी लगा के पूरे घर के वोल्टेज और करंट को ऑपरेट कर सकते हैं?
If you
instead of installing both.
Yes. Basically, MCB cannot control. Okay, it only gives you protection. See, MCB is suppose. Okay, I am giving you one example. Okay, the in your study room there is one fan, there is one light, and you are using your laptop and mobile. Okay, so when you are using your fan and light, there is one switchboard. Okay. So suppose they are taking this light and fan, they are taking maximum 2 ampere. Okay. So if you use only MCB, if you use only MCB of 32 ampere or 10 ampere, then your cost will be a little bit high. Okay. You can use the you have to use their fuse. Where you will use the MCB? You will use the MCB from the supply position where your energy meter is there. Okay, घर में energy meter है ना, जहाँ से तुम लोग reading लेते हो, जहाँ पे electricity office से कोई person आता है reading लेके जाता है, उस जगह पे MCB board लगाना better है. Because instead of using a small amount of current MCB, if you use high current MCB, like instead of 10 ampere MCB, if you use 32 ampere MCB, two room of your houses will be protected using that MCB. Okay, and then use a single fuse in separate houses. Okay, that is the normal procedure. Because in your separate room, if you use the MCB, your connection will be much more complicated.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes,
sir. Okay. Any other question?
No, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay. Okay, so all of you give your attendance in the chat box. Thank you, everyone. So we will meet again on Monday. Okay. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.